Good morning. Thank you for joining us for our coverage of the International Space Station's Expedition 34 mission. Here in the International Space Station Flight Control Room at the Johnson Space Center, the Orbit 2 team is on duty. They're being led by Flight Director David Korth, who is shown here in the long-sleeve blue shirt. He is being supported by Capcom's Mark Reagan and Kathy Bolt, both of those serving as the Capcom for this team and representing the crew office. They are also the voice of the flight control team as needed with the on-orbit crew. Today, on orbit, the crew is back to their normal schedule. They had been sleep shifted the last few days in support of the Progress launch and docking activities that occurred earlier this week. The crew of Commander Kevin Ford, NASA astronauts Tom Marshburn, Canadian Space Agency astronaut Chris Hadfield, and cosmonauts Evgeny Turelkin, Roman Romanenko, and Oleg Novitsky are in the mid-afternoon of their crew day. They woke at midnight and had personal time and hygiene before breakfast and their start-a-day daily planning conference, which is a chance to tag up with all of their supporting flight control teams around the world. They also had a start-of-the-day inputs for the journal study, which is an ongoing study to understand behavioral and human issues experienced during long-duration missions that can help prepare support systems for future missions beyond low Earth orbit. To start the day, Commander Kevin Ford also had a reaction self-test, which is another ongoing study for most crew members on board. This is a portable 5-minute reaction time test that allows crew members to monitor daily effects of fatigue on their performance while on board the International Space Station. He also worked on a bit of management, stowage management rather, and also continued work on the internal thermal control system, refilling some of the cooling loops in the Destiny laboratory. His morning also included workout activities on board, each crew member, of course, scheduled for at least 2 hours of exercise each day, and this is to help minimize bone and muscle loss that's experienced during long-duration missions. His counterpart, NASA astronaut Tom Marshburn, also had the reaction self-test this morning and also routine inspection of the vehicle. He's also been working on the combustion integration rack, performing some inspections as well as hardware removal and reconfigurations and temperature checks. His morning also included exercise on the SEVIS, which is the onboard cycle, as well as the ARED, or Advanced Resistive Exercise Device, which replicates lifting weights in space. Their fellow cosmonauts also had a busy day, also primarily focused on hardware maintenance. They also completed a relocation of a control panel for the ATB, or Automated Transfer Vehicle, as well as inspection of the vehicle, computer reboots, and also a panel test in the service module. They also spent a significant portion of their morning on the transfer of supplies and equipment that did arrive in the Progress vehicle that will continue throughout the week. After their midday meal, the work continued on board. Commander Kevin Ford had two routine private medical conferences, and then Ford was joined by Marshburn and Hadfield to begin a series of onboard training sessions. This is part of a series leading up to the SpaceX 2 mission. They had a rendezvous and robotics training reviews, and will also have a conference with their training team today as they ready for the arrival of Dragon, which is scheduled for early March. Flight engineer Chris Hadfield also continued work on the InSpace 3 experiment, which is investigating the structure of aggregates from colloidal emulsions. This particular experiment obtains data on fluids containing unique shaped particles and changes the physical properties of the fluids in response to magnetic fields. While he worked on that, again, flight engineer Tom Marshburn worked on pre-pack for the Dragon spacecraft, and their cosmonaut colleagues continued with Progress unloading as well as some other scientific experiment work, including work on the Senior Ocean Observation Study. Again, the crew is in the mid-afternoon of their crew day. They'll continue with their work for the next couple of hours. They're scheduled for their end-of-day daily planning conference just before 1 p.m. Central Time. Then they'll have their shared evening meal and some off-duty time. They have a few final experiment tasks before they retire. That includes observations and photographs of some of the Earth observation studies that are being done on board. They're scheduled for crew sleep at 3:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control, Houston.